This episode of D News is brought to you by Bloom.
Happy Mother's Day!
I got you a gift.
Oh, you know that's not really my... Oh, gin!
Yeah.
Sweet, my kids are gonna love this.
Hey guys, Trace and Tara here for D News with an interesting new study about doing it.
Yes, thank you, Trace. The Proceedings of the Royal Society B published a comprehensive analysis of birth rates and found that peak birth months vary based on latitude. Very interesting. So the further north you live from the equator, the more likely you are to have a baby earlier in the year.
Interesting. The study looked at 118 different countries, mostly in the northern hemisphere, and the pattern was pretty consistent across the board. Places that are further north, like France, see more births between May and July, whereas places like the Caribbean tend to peak around October.
Yeah, interestingly, this pattern also applies to states within the U.S. So currently, the nationwide peak happens around early to mid-August. That's actually true for the entire world as well. It's not just us. But in southern states specifically, like Florida, it doesn't happen until around October. Utah actually has the earliest peak of the year in late June. But aside from a few exceptions like that, the majority of America sees their peaks in the last 4 months of the year.
So, using math,
yes,
which I love to do, we can surmise that people in the South are doing it more in the winter, and people in the North are doing it in the autumn.
Yes, you did good math.
Thank you.
Please stop saying doing it.
Okay.
But can you explain why that pattern exists?
Well, I always kind of assumed that people had more sex during the holidays.
That's actually a pretty safe assumption. Condom sales do tend to spike in December, which would line up with the high number of August births. Mm-hmm.
And biology has to be a factor too, right? So I do recall a study that said that men's sperm concentration is highest in the spring and lowest in the autumn.
Also true. And even things like the weather, we can't completely discount. If I was a woman and I lived in the South, I would probably do everything in my power to avoid being 9 months pregnant during July, because that just sounds miserable.
Pregnancy in general, actually, to me sounds pretty miserable.
Yeah, you're
right. Aren't half of all pregnancies in the US unplanned? Even the ones that are planned probably don't take into account the weather.
Also true, and we haven't even considered things like miscarriages, case in point. Studies show that fetuses are most vulnerable to toxins during the third month of pregnancy. So if people are having a lot of sex in autumn, then that might mean that flu season could theoretically carry a higher number of miscarriages.
This is a lot more complicated than I would have thought.
Yeah, truth is we have no idea why births happen more in certain places in certain times, so we may as well just embrace it.
That's the spirit.
Yes, it is. And while we're on the topic of expecting, any new mother can tell you that researching baby products is an overwhelming task. But with Bloom, you can sit back and let the experts do the work for you. Bloom helps you discover the best baby and toddler products on the market by delivering monthly boxes of top-rated goods like toys, bath products, food, clothing, and more.
Each box is 100% personalized for you and your little one and contains 5 full-size products tailored to your child's age, gender, and developmental stage. You can head over to bloom.com/dnews and use the code REV3 to get half off your first month, and they have discounts on long-term subscriptions too.
Yes, good for those of you who have waited until the very last second for Mother's Day gifts. In the meantime, if you guys have questions or comments about this episode, or maybe you just want to calculate what month your parents had sex in, feel free to do so. We won't tell. Just leave your comments down below and subscribe here for more videos.